Hello, my name is Alan Plehancic. I'm the lead designer of Tuner software, and I'm excited to tell you that Tuner 2.5 has been launched today. We at Simucube are extremely excited that all our devices are in now one software, be it wheelbases, active pedals, or steering wheels. We are thankful for our community for participating in open beta and giving us great feedback, which helped us immensely. And we hope you do it also in the future. You know who you are, and keep your voices loud because we are really, really listening. So what's new with the Tuner 2.5? We added support for our Simucube 2 wheelbases. We added also for our steering wheels, LED configuration and button remapping. We changed our profile view to overview, which now allows you to change profiles much easier for all devices. And we also implemented automatic profile switching. Today with me is Joni Hämäläinen, who is our junior software engineer.
Hi.
And he was a main contributor of porting the Simucube 2 into the tuner. So how would you describe what is new into the tuner software with Simucube 2?
Well, in regards to the new features, of course, we have the new torque linearity filter that allows the user to reduce or boost the lower small torque signals. And it was previously only available on the Simucube 2 Ultimate models, but we have made it now work and available on the Sport and Pro models as well.
How was the paddock impacted with this new change?
Paddock works the same way it did before. And now it's just integrated with the tuner software itself directly, and you can use it the same way, but the upload function is for now disabled and you can only use the profiles uploaded with the TrueDrive software. But we are working on it, and at some point you will have the upload feature in Tuner as well.
So Antti, what changes were implemented in Tuner 2.5 regarding steering wheels?
Tuner 2.5 got two major improvements regarding steering wheels. The first is that you can now remap all the buttons to your liking. So if you have more than one wheel, then when you are changing wheels, the buttons do the same thing without needing to configure in games every time you use them. And the other one was that now you can actually make LED profiles with Valo GT23 wheel. Previously, they were just fixed LED profiles that we made, but now you can configure them to your liking.
And anything you want to say to the community regarding the steering wheel?
Well, we are always listening for feedback from the community. So even though not all of us in the SimCube write to the Discord all the time, but we sure do read the comments and try to understand what's the problems behind all the issues that our customers have, and really try to come up with the best solutions for those.
Here with me is Lassi Hämäläinen, the software architect and the original designer of our profile handling. So Lassi, could you tell us why did we split our profiles and change the profile view to overview?
Originally, tuner profiles have been like one profile for all devices. So when you change the profile, feeling of all pedals changes. But this didn't feel anymore the correct approach that when we brought the SimCube 2 and wireless wheels to the tuner. So when we start having many different types of devices, just produces too many different profiles that make it really difficult to handle. So it's right now maybe a bit more work to switch all the profiles for every device because, well, there's many profiles now. But we implemented automatic profile switching to handle these use cases when you really like to have a separate profile for all your devices for every car and so on.
Any particular reason why we specifically wanted to implement automatic profile switching?
Automatic profile switching has been requested by the community a lot and for a long time. And finally, we kind of have had all the components to actually implement it. With the tuner, we got all the telemetry data from the games, so we know which car is in use. And now that SimCube 2 is also in the tuner, we can implement this same system for all our devices.
So this is Tuner 2.5. And you can now download it from our website. If you have any further suggestions, we will be listening and we'll be adjusting based on your feedback. And one more thing, we are mapping out interest for a rudder feature for our active pedals. So if you have any interest regarding that, please follow the link below in the description. I thank you, and we at Simucube thank you very much for listening, and hopefully you have fun with Tuner 2.5. Have fun time racing.